Welcome to today's episode of How the Gamers Work. We are in Moscow for the three-day candidates tournament of 2016. This particular game, round 12 of that tournament, was played on the 25th of March 2016. Sergei Karyakin with the white pieces, Veselin Topalov with the black pieces. And we begin e4, and we have c5, which is in round 12 of the tournament, two rounds before the end, the first time that the Sicilian defense has made its presence at this tournament. Continuing, knight f3, d6, d4, c takes, knight takes, knight f6, knight g3, a6, h3, e6, g4, knight f3, d7, bishop e3, bishop e7. And continuing, d5, d5, a3, b7, h4, castles, queen d2, knight d6, h5. White, while black has a pretty harmonious development, as you can see here, white has already got his attack rolling. Continuing, knight and h to d7, g6, forcing the attack even further, knight e5, and white castles long. Keep that the rook queen combination running up the d5, while you've got the queen bishop combination running up towards h6. All fairly classical white attacking maneuvers as far as the Sicilian is concerned. Continuing, knight g to c4, bishop c4, knight at c4, queen e2, and rook c8. Which proved to be the error of the game. Instead, Topalov should have looked at something along the lines of bishop f6, which would leave a fairly perfectly acceptable position. If you look at h6, h6, g6, h6, g7, bishop takes g7, you've got a very playable game for black. But Topalov played with c8, which immediately allowed the attack to roll even further with h6. Topalov played f takes g6. Karyakin came in with the knight. Knight takes e6, applying even more pressure onto the king side. Queen d7, and obviously knight f8. The only thing we could possibly think of here is, if we take things back slightly, is that Topalov must have completely forgotten about that combination altogether and been thinking only about the possibility of Karyakin playing something along the lines of h takes g7. And he completely misread the situation and didn't see a completely elementary beginner level fork coming into play. Bishop takes an f8, h takes a g7, bishop takes a g7, bishop d4, and now white has completely secured his position, clearly stands better, has the exchange, and plus still maintains massive pressure into the king side. And as you can imagine, with players of this caliber taking such a massive, not only material but positional advantage, it's just a case of solid technique and playing the patterns will carry the game through to a successful conclusion, and that's exactly what Karyakin does here. After a5, bishop takes in g7, queen takes in g7, queen g4, rook e8, queen g5, bishop c6, queen h6, queen h8, b3, knight takes in a3, rook h3. And the knight taking an a3 just literally puts that black knight completely out of the game and weren't able to get back out over to defend at all. Bishop d7, rook g3, queen f6, rook h1, rook e7, queen h4, queen g7, knight d5, rook f7, queen d8 with check. Queen f8, queen takes in a5, knight takes in c2, and without waiting for Kyriakou to phase this move, Topalov just resigned immediately anyway. And that, my friends, is how the game was won, and the game that has taken Kyriakou up to the verge of becoming the next candidate to play Regis Carlsen for the World Championship in New York City. Please post any comments, questions, criticisms you may have in the comment section down below. Don't forget to share this out to all your chess friends, click the thumbs up button if you like this type of content, and remember to hit the subscribe button as well to stay subscribed to my channel for all new content that comes out on a week-to-week basis. Remember to stay proud of the win. I'll see you next time. Cheers.